Hi everyone, I'm Warren Ruziak from Atlassian, and welcome back to our series on how to create a developer experience platform using Compass. All teams have standards for how they build and deploy their software. These teams include, but are not limited to, languages, tools, and infrastructure. Setting up these things every time a developer wants to build something is time-consuming, error-prone, and often uninteresting. In this video, we're going to take a look at Compass templates. Compass templates help developers focus on building cool software and solving interesting problems by automating the setup and configuration of a team's standard tool set. First, we're going to take a look at the three things a Compass template does when it's executed. Then we're going to see a demo of Compass templates setting up a new repository. And finally, we're going to see how to create a Compass template from scratch. In the last three videos of this video series, we have shown how to create a new instance of Compass and populate the software catalog using GitHub, how to onboard your engineering organization by assigning components to owners, and how to create scorecards in Compass. Now, let's take a look at Compass templates. Okay, we're going to start by taking a look at what Compass templates do when you invoke them. First, Compass templates create a new repository by cloning an existing repository that you set up as a starting point. The starting point repository acts as a common base for development projects of a specific kind. For example, if your team writes Golang code that is executed in AWS Lambda, the starting point repository might be a Golang repository with an AWS SAM template file and a standard Golang Lambda main and handler. If your team writes C++ code that uses CMake, Google Test, and Boost, the starting point repository might have a source directory with a main.cpp, a test directory, and a CMake list.txt file that imports Google Test and Boost and successfully builds them. The goal of the starting point repository is to give your developers a team best practice compliant starting point for their work. The second thing Compass templates do is they create a new Compass component based on the newly created repository. Finally, Compass templates invoke a webhook and pass it a JSON payload. This is where the heavy lifting happens. Your team can build the webhook handler any way they want, have it do anything they want. Some examples include updating the newly created Compass component by adding metrics, scorecards, and integration with your team's feature flagging and monitoring tools. Setting up standards compliant CI/CD to build, test, and deploy your new code to your test, staging, and production environments. Another thing they can do is provision infrastructure that your code depends on, such as AWS, DynamoDB tables, S3 buckets, or Kinesis streams. Compass templates do all the busy work for developers when they're bootstrapping a new project, allowing them to focus on building cool software and solving interesting problems. I'm going to start off with a quick demo of how Compass templates work. Particularly, we're going to invoke this C++ demo template. What this template's going to do is it's going to clone a starting point repository. Then it's going to create a Compass component for us. Then it's going to invoke a webhook. And that webhook's going to do a couple things. Webhook's going to add a bitbucket pipeline.yaml file to our new repository. It's going to configure Bitbucket by enabling pipelines and adding some deployments. And then it's going to create a DynamoDB table in AWS using a CloudFormation template and the AWS CloudFormation Go API. Before we run this, let's take a quick look at our starting point repository. So we jump over this tab, we see we have a really simple C++ repository. Source directory has a main.cpp. There's a CMake list.txt file. We don't have a Bitbucket pipeline.yaml file in here. The configuration of our CI/CD is going to be completely handled by our webhook. If we take a quick look at the CMake list file, we can see it's been tokenized. We have a replace me. The webhook is also going to come in here and update all of these tokens with appropriate values. So now let's go back and let's run that per template. To run the template, we're going to click use. We're going to give it a name. We're going to give it a quick description. We're going to choose an owning team. And we're going to choose a Bitbucket project. Then we're going to click Next. Now we come to the parameter screen. When you create a Compass template, you're given the option to add as many parameters as you want, along with default values for each one. And then when the template is invoked, you can either use the default values or set custom values. This allows you to tell the webhook what to do in specific situations. Maybe you can have a parameter that tells you whether to enable feature flags or not, whether to connect specific kinds of monitoring tools, which CI/CD platform to use. The options are endless, so you can do whatever you want with this. We're just going to leave these at the default values for now, and we're going to click Next. And then we're going to click Create. Now that the template is run successfully, let's jump over to Bitbucket
And let's refresh our repository view. And we can now see our test template repository that was just created. If we click on it, we can see we have our familiar structure. There's our source directory with our main file. There's our CMake list, but we also now have a Bitbucket file. And we can see from the commit message that this was committed from the webhook Lambda. If we drill into our CMake list, that replace me token has been replaced by the name of our repository. Now the other thing we can do is we can drill into repository settings. We can scroll down, we can take a look at settings, and we can see that Bitbucket pipelines has been enabled. By default, this is not enabled. This was something the webhook set up for us using the Bitbucket API. If we click on deployments, we also have a bunch of deployments set up. These are again not here by default. The webhook came in and made changes using the Bitbucket API. So if we click back, we click on pipelines, we can also see that we've got a pipeline that's running. So we added a Bitbucket pipeline.yaml file. We set up pipelines correctly, and now we've got our code being built and deployed to our test and staging environments. From here, let's jump over to Compass. We take a look at our component view, and if we refresh this, we now have a new component, test template. If we click on this, this was all generated for us automatically by the Compass template. We can see that it's linked to our Bitbucket repository, and we can see the activity panel has some activity in it. If we click activity, we can see a little more detail. There's been a successful deployment. If we click on this, we can drill in and see that Bitbucket has actually done a deployment for us. The last thing we're going to do is jump over to CloudFormation really quickly. And we can see already that we've got this DynamoDB CloudFormation for test template. So this was just created a little while ago. And if we jump over to DynamoDB and we click refresh, we can see we now have a table for test template. This uses CloudFormation and some CloudFormation template files stored in an S3 bucket. So you could basically provision any infrastructure you could possibly want using your webhook. All right, let's jump back over to templates. And let's go through how we go about creating a new template. So if we click on templates, we can click create. We come to this screen, we can give it a name. We can choose a team that owns this particular template, and we have to give it a repository link. So again, we've already set up our starting point repository, so we can copy this and we can paste it into here, and we can click next. This screen, you can set up your webhook or endpoint. This can be anything you want. You write the code for this and you provide this. This is also where you can add your parameters. So if we wanted to make a foo parameter with the default value of foo, we can do that. And if we take a look at payload, this is the JSON payload that's actually going to be sent to your webhook. So you're going to get a component ID, a component name, the repository that's supposed to be created, or that was created, and a list of parameters. Now if you click next, you basically get a summary of this, and then you click finish.
All right, thank you for watching this video about Compass templates. Compass templates help developers focus on building cool software and solving interesting problems by automating the setup and configuration of a team standard toolset. In this video, we learned about the three things a Compass template does when it's executed. Then we saw a demo of a Compass template setting up and configuring a new Bitbucket repository, Bitbucket pipelines for CI/CD, a Compass component, and some AWS infrastructure. Finally, we saw how to create a new Compass template. Thank you for watching.